anime. Who is anime? Is this an anime? If this is an anime, then why is he crying? Shh. No more tears. And if this is called Neon Jellyfish, then why can't I find any? Do you want to watch Neon Jellyfish? Or does your wife tell you to grow up, or else she's taken the kids to her mother's? And where has my wife gone? Anime explaining iVideo guess. We start off our journey in the distant future, 2015. The sea levels have risen, allowing the fish people to thrive. And is that a fucking kaiju? Traffic seems to be a thing of the past.
Must be nice.
Everyone has died, except for this woman. She lives, because of reasons. She's in search for a child. He's probably dead. Oh look, there he is. Here we meet our protagonist, Bitch Boy. Bitch Boy is here to use a phone, which, surprisingly, doesn't fucking work. How upsetting. How is he gonna be able to call his Discord kitten now?
Mommy?
As we see here, this story takes place in a parallel universe. We know this because not in a million years would Puss Boy get a sexy Polaroid of Tits McGee over here, complete with kiss marks and a note telling the little boy to look at her tits.
I'm not jealous, I'm just disappointed.
Bitch Boy sees a ghost girl and pisses his pants, very spooky, and Satan joins the call to fuck some shit up.
Walking in like a fucking Chad,
Bitch Boy shits his pants. And we see that this gentle giant is here to preach the good word about our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Unfortunately, the army as a whole are all atheists and launch the world's cum reserves at the altar boy. It was not very effective. The heavenly messenger believes that the only way to get through to these people is to blast them with its love beam.
It was super effective.
These people will now be joining God in heaven.
How wholesome.
The heavenly beam pieces out and ascends to a new plane of existence. Bitch Boy survives this because of Big Mummy Milkers.
Hey there.
The celestial being catches his fucking missile and a blast to the face like a fucking Chad. Unnamed Man 3 is upset that the missiles didn't work on killing his sleep paralysis demon. So he suggests to use more missiles.
I don't see a problem with this.
You know, it almost worked the first time. I can't see anything possibly going wrong with this. Bitch Boy gets a look at these grade A titties. He restrains himself, of course, because he's a giant cuck. And instead of touching, he burns the visual into his memory so he can later use it for his nightly JO sessions. They survive this. They managed to flip the car over because they were just built different, I guess. To be fair, I doubt Shindy did shit.
The blast was massive.
That's what he said. Also, Satan survives. Big surprise.
For someone with such a cute face, you sure are uptight.
Still not sure what kind of relationship this is, but I'll let it play out. Women drivers.
My father works there, doesn't he?
That's right. And do you know what it is your father does?
Shinji, he bends me over and yanks on my titties, Shinji. He gets all up in there and shoves his love in me, Shinji. Don't you see, Shinji? He rides me like a fucking stallion with his massive horse dick.
A teacher once told me that he has the admirable job of defending humanity.
Defending humanity? That's what we tell the fucking taxpayers to shut them the fuck up.
What are your intentions?
We're gonna need more hookers, a little bit of blow, and at least 3 Viagra. It's gonna be a long night in the office. I hope you're prepared.
Are we on the way to go see my father right now?
Daddy issues. Hooters hands off top secret files to a 14-year-old boy. Now, I might not be the sharpest tool in the shed, but that seems like a severe and continuous lapse in judgment.
Is that a robot?
Is that a robot? No, 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 no. This young boy, this is Patricia. She likes sex doll, but better. She make you a good wife. Yes, it's a fucking robot. Why am I Jamaican?
You will be its pilot.
Huh? I'm supposed to jump inside and fight whatever I saw out there?
Would you rather go out there and not fight the giant fucking kaiju? Ultimately being its plaything? I feel like premeditated aggravated assault is your best option here. I mean, self-defense, Your Honor.
No! I don't want to!
Neon Genesis Teenage Rebellion. We're then introduced to Ghost Girl. Is she dead? I don't know. Hello? Wait. She's got a good personality. Bitch Boy survives this because of plot armor.
Get in the Ava.
I'll be its pilot.
Simp.
Wait, what is this?
Shinji becomes a pony in a jar and fucking dies.
Just deal with it. Come on, be a big boy.
Yes, ma'am, anything for you. Fucking step on me. Before he can fly, Bitch Boy must learn how to walk, and instead falls over like a toddler, and starts getting used like a fucking fleshlight. We learn that the pilot and the robot are connected, and anything the robot feels, Shinji also feels. Can we just take a moment to imagine what that fucking pitch meeting would be like? Oh yes, hello, thanks for having me.
You say you have a way to fight the angels.
Yes, picture this. Tall people. We fight them with tall people.
That's going to be more expensive than my last divorce. Not to mention the time and resources.
No, I actually have some at home next to my trash can. Yeah, I made them out of cardboard, plastic, aluminium foil, glad of course, can't be too stingy, a stray pube and some poo.
How would we control these robots? Maybe with a controller or something like an Xbox Kinect, so our pilots stay safe.
No, we get pubescent boys and girls, I don't discriminate, I hate them both equally, and we put them in the robot. We then attach a short but very fragile power cord on the back of them so that whenever an angel shows up, we actually, we fight them on our doorstep, causing millions of dollars of property damage.
I see, and they will be protected thanks to the rough outer shell.
Yes, they sure will, but they will feel everything that the robot does.
And who do I make the checkout to?
You die in the robot, you die in real life. After getting penetrated the night before, Shinji wakes up in a cold sweat. The same can't be said for Shinji's robot because it woke up in John Wayne Gacy's basement.
Air conditioning is humanity's greatest invention.
You fucking what? You've made 40 meter tall metal people. I'll let this slide because I want you to sit on my face, but don't let this happen again.
Once the Evas in this city are fully operational, things might work out.
Oh, you think we have a chance?
Have a chance? Did you see what happened last night? Shinji fought like a fucking deformed eye with several missing limbs, a fucking speech impediment, and a fucking crack addiction. You're telling me that you're putting your faith in a 14-year-old boy with fucking daddy issues. You guys are royally fucked.
Instead of living all alone by himself, Shinji will live with me.
Milkbags tries to arrange a completely platonic sleepover party with a 14-year-old. And succeeds.
And don't worry, it's not like I'm gonna try any funny business with some kid.
Foreshadowing.
Welcome home.
So he's dead, right? She just fucking murdered him?
It's a little messy right now, but don't worry about it, okay?
A little?
Nah, they're just trying to put the P in the V. Why did I... Bit of late night bonking, bit of how's your father, diddling. So they fucked, right? It's not just me.
Isn't this so fun?
Ugh. Are you watching this alone? Did you bring the lotion? Have this bottle of shampoo. You disgust me. You know, I'm more of a boob man myself, but for you, baby, I can be anything. So he fucked that penguin, right? We get a flashback of how Bitch Boy survived.
The Ava has reactivated.
Impossible. It's completely non-operational.
You fucking what? See that? It moves. So I have concluded with my detective brain that it is, in fact, operational. You can thank me later. Shinji deus machinas that shit and starts a night of consensual and passionate lovemaking. And like a gentleman, he leaves in the morning to provide for his family. Just like my father. We then get an exposition dump telling us that a rock fell from heaven, violated the South Pole, drenching millions in fluids, killing half of them. Bitch Boy gets a message asking if he is the pilot of that robot, and like an idiot, says yes. You know, I'm starting to believe he did not read the top secret file. I feel like that would have been rule one. Bitch Boy gets beaten up for his Pokemon cards. He's then fucking king hit by fucking bully number three because he realizes he doesn't have a holographic Charizard. My sleep paralysis demon is spotted off in the distance and all the rich people decide to peace the fuck out. You know, faster than my father. Leaving the rest of the population to fucking deal with it. How brave. Squidward arrives like a big dick in a locker room.
We don't need them to tell us to launch our Avas.
Boobzilla has faith that the poor people will be able to beat up the massive schlong without the Avas. So they launch the Avas anyway. These boys disregard bathroom etiquette by standing next to each other at the piss station while not holding hands. Bitch Boy gets taken advantage of by the hentai monster and gets fucking numb flashbacks. He struggles for a bit, but in the end, his hose gets circumcised. Cthulhu throws Shinji like a fucking used condom, almost crushing the piss boys, because they're here for some reason. I don't know. Shinji indulges in rope play. Oi, dickhead, let us in. Fucking Satan's over there with a strap on ready to fuck us in the ass. If you let us in, we'll give you a fucking kick-up bar.
Well, isn't he gonna fight back?
Maybe he's not fighting back because of us. He can't move because we're in the way.
You think? Bitch Boy yanks on the phallus's two pubes and launches it directly into my ass. Shinji arms himself with a knife and a threat and shanks the little man in the boat like a fucking psychopath. And just like every woman in my life, gets immediately turned off. This traumatizes little Bitch Boy and he runs away listening to Billy Joel Piano Man. With the main protagonist out of the way, these boys wanted to recreate a porno with Rack City here, with no success.
Dude, she was such a hottie.
Bitch Boy finds out about this and, like a fucking man, punches this kid right in the face hole. This robot finds out that you're not subscribed and fucking cries about it, launching Emo Girl directly into a brick wall. Robot is still sad and this, charming girl survives the head trauma.
The first hypothesis would be that the pilot's mental state was unstable.
Unstable? No. She just ate some dick cheese that didn't agree with her. I'm assuming she's just lactose intolerant. But hey, that's just my theory. My film theory.
Perhaps. No.
What? What is it?
Nothing. Couldn't possibly be correct.
Fucking spit it out! And I'm not talking about the fucking cheese! If you think it's something, don't you think it would be important to, I don't know, share with the class? Maybe what you're thinking is exactly what's happening in this situation. Maybe. But what the fuck do I know? All I know is weeb shit and dick cheese. Turns out they're keeping a demon baby in the basement. That seems fucking safe. Scientist I am! Keep Satan in the basement I must! Graduate high school I did not! Too fucking stupid I am! Experiment on it I must! I apologize that I butchered the fuck out of that. Bitch Boy discovers my sex dungeon and walks in. Every day God tests me. It's a fucking good thing that I don't have a thing for petite girls with blue hair. This is just simply unfair. Bitch Boy gets a handful of boob and I get a handful of depression while I watch this. Balance, just like all things should be.
Your card was renewed and I brought it here for you.
Smooth. Real smooth.
Sorry about what happened.
About what?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe the sudden, unexpected Bible study that just took place where we did nothing but talk about our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I guess she doesn't like Jesus. Also, you get what you fucking deserve, you little bitch. You disgust me. I just realized I had to be somewhere, actually. To pray. Yes. That's what I need to do. Yo, what the fuck is this? Did someone fucking smear shit on my screen? Yo, it's ET, guys. Lube up your buttholes. These guys are thorough. What in the fucking geometry is that? Looks like my calculus homework that I didn't do. Too busy fucking self-loathing. Who the fuck did you piss off? You, my boy, are getting used like the only fleshlight in a frat house.
What's Shinji's condition?
He's alive.
He's fucking what? Holy mother of plot armor.
The pilot's brainwaves are unstable.
Bro, I could have told you that months ago. He's always been unstable. Unlike that light. Perhaps more unstable than my ex-girlfriends. No, you're right, I took them all from the insane asylum. Oh, good times. But he is pretty fucked up.
Begin heart massage.
Begin heart massage? Someone looks like they had a good time. Lucky bastard. Oh, hi, Satan. Satan, please, for the love of God, keep it PG.
It's safe to conclude that anything entering this range will be hit by its accelerated particle cannon. Utilizing close quarters combat by the Ava will be too dangerous.
Fucking nerd.
It's basically impenetrable and deadly.
You know what else is impenetrable? My love for Jesus. And my wife.
What's the current status of Unit 1's designated pilot?
Psychologically speaking, he's fine.
But physically, yeah, he is fucked, yeah. He looks like a taxidermic roadkill with a tumor, tuberculosis, a hemorrhoid, and probably bronchitis as well. Wait, no, my apologies. He's always looked like that.
We don't have a favorable hand here, do we?
See, this is why I use my feet. Fast forward through heavy exposition and dialogue, and they get a fucking gun, and Bitch Boy wakes up in his soiled panties.
These are your roles and responsibilities for this operation. You will be the gunner in Unit 1.
Positrons are affected by Earth's rotation, its magnetic field, and gravity. They do not travel in a straight path. You must correct for these factors. Do not forget that. Hit the core and only the core. Precision is paramount.
But I've never practiced anything like that before.
Yeah, I'm with Bitch Boy here. I'm older, therefore wiser, and I understood nothing of that. He's like 12 and his track record for not fucking shit up is shit at best.
So then what happens if I miss and the target shoots back at me?
Well, have you seen Indiana Jones in the Raiders of the Lost Ark where the Nazi guy's face gets melted off? Yeah, like that, but worse. Bitch Boy loads up his super soaker and the cylinder says, "No you." They cross streams and make sure that they miss each other because they aren't gay. Maybe. Shock to everyone, Bitch Boy fails, and the pizza box just stands there. Menacingly. As it continues to fuck the earth with its giant massive dragon dildo. Oh look at that, we have penetration! Ah! The AllSpark goes for round 2, and they survive this because of literal plot armor. Bitch Boy pulls up, pulls out, and pulls the trigger, sending Rom the Rhombus straight to Jesus. Oh, okay, yeah, no, we're all thinking it. Blue Girl's robot looks like melted butter, and squirts out more than my ass does on taco night. Bitch Boy struggles to open door. That's embarrassing.
Are you know me?
Fuck off, she's mine. Bitch Boy pees out of his eyes, which I find very impressive.
Why are you crying, Ikari?
Because he's a pussy! Nah, I ain't see nothing. I'm blind in my left eye and like 43% blind in my right eye. I don't see much of nothing, actually. Itchy tits! These boys arrive to see if they can get a peek at the goods. But instead of tits, they get the middle finger. Fuck off, small dicks, you're gonna have to pay for this pussy! Tokyo drifting in a school, 10 for technique, I'll give you that, but I'm sorry. It's a zero for casualties. These boys get their first boner. You can too with the low price of $10.99 plus shipping. T's and C's apply, we are not responsible for faulty products.
You are one thick dude.
Damn, boy, thick!
What are the Avas?
Fucking robot, isn't it?
I smell blood in the entry plug.
Ah, no, sorry, that's just Roger. He just loves shoving his murder victims in the plug holes.
15 years ago, humanity first discovered a humanoid object they referred to as an angel in the Antarctic.
Fucking Santa, wasn't it? Fucking knew that guy was shady. Unnamed Company 3 thought it was a good idea to make their own robot for money, and they launched it. The only difference between these robots and the Avas is that these ones aren't controlled by pubescent teenagers. Bet this can't go wrong. Oh shit, it all went wrong. Millions will die. This robot is on the run, wanted by police for DUI, battery, and a misdemeanor.
How exactly are you planning on stopping it?
By good old-fashioned human touch.
Yeah, she's gonna jerk off the robot with its massive robot dick. A couple of pumps just to stop it from doing its murder spree. Shut up and don't question it, Karen. My boy is fucking frolicking without a care. Unaware that it's about to get fucked up. Bitch Boy drops out of the plane and doesn't fucking die. Sure, okay. And he starts Naruto running just like me in high school. I just think this is funny, I just want to include it. Bitch Boy pulls up and grabs wacky, waving, inflatable arm flailing tube man. Let's be honest, I was not gonna be able to say that without reading that. Telling that it's dangerous to go alone and to take this woman. Sugar Tits arrives and puts in the password to turn it off. But oh no, it's the wrong password! So instead of running away before it explodes to make Bitch Boy deal with it, she does the only logical thing, I guess, and fucking starts pushing shit. I don't know. I guess pushing the robot's rods fucking did something, cause it worked. I don't know. Itchy Tits!